speaking of, Barry Mills is finishing his term at the college this year, and there are many ways that we're going to celebrate him. But this magnificent hall was the work of many people, but above all, the perseverance and the vision of Barry Mills. He's been a great friend of the arts and a great friend of music. Not only did he turn a swimming pool into a fantastic concert hall that our students take for granted, but he also, when the Mellon Foundation came to him for a President's Arts Fund, said that one of his top priorities was the ability to bring performers to the college. So we've had Cedar Walton, Joe Lovano, we've had Marcus Roberts, Terry Carrington. What many people don't know is that Cedar Walton, Joe Lovano were names that Barry suggested from that fund and said, can we bring them to the college? So we wanted to celebrate what he's done by having a concert that we thought he would especially enjoy. And that's what brings us Cyrus Chestnut and his trio tonight. So enjoy jazz with us and thanks Barry.
Certainly good to be here. Never been here before. Hopefully after tonight it won't be the last. But I'm very honored to be here in your presence. Thank you for allowing us to share a little bit of ourselves. And for the next few minutes, that's what you'll hear. You will hear our story. Where we have come, where we are now, and hopefully where we are to go. The notes that you're about to hear, we had not played before, and that's true. If we did, and if we played them in the same way, then what you will be hearing a repertory performance, and that's not necessarily what improvisation is about. I like to think of improvisation as composition at a very rapid pace without the chance of editing. So, yeah. So, you know, the basic rules of rhythm, melody, and harmony still exist, but we're just doing it at real time, you know, and we're throwing out the erasers. So you can say after tonight, they play just for us. Notes that you are designed for your ears. And so we hope you enjoy it. Now, give me a second, let me take time to introduce the man.
Hey, man.
We'll get all of this out the way right now. So once we get started, we can just go right on through. I'm going to take the time to introduce to you on drums, a type of this music, a great educator. Recorded on many records. Fortunately, he agrees to play with me every once in a while.
Yeah, right.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Cleveland, Ohio, Mr. Neal Smith. And tonight I have the privilege of being able to work with a Midwest.
Say that right? Midwest
rhythm section, you know? Not down south, not up south, west south, whatever. Midwest. This young gentleman, it's one night in New York, a place called Smoke. You know, he played, and then after he came up to play with the second band, it's like, whoa. So Saturday, I was like, whoa. I was like, hey, man, think I'd call you again? He says, uh-huh. So he's here. Another gentleman from Cleveland, Ohio, Mr. Devin Starks. That being said, the journey will now start. There are CDs in the lobby, you know what to do. Thank you. Hope you enjoy yourselves.
Thank you. Thank you.
very much, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Neal Smith. Mr. Chestnut. You will understand, young man, that sometimes I might tell you something in the back as far as the set message and change it. That's what happens. So, now you know. We hope that you enjoy it. Okay, okay. Started with an original, with a great original by the great Frank Lesser entitled I've Never Been in Love Before, followed by our interpretation of a Lionel Richie classic entitled Hello. And going back to Jazz 101, All the Things You Are, we hope you enjoy that. There's all of these pieces here that are hollering at me, and they want their turn. kind of like, you know, kids in the elementary school, around third or fourth grade. I think by the time the kids get to fifth grade, they start getting cool, you know. Teacher, you know, asks, who wants to come up to the board? And all hands, you know, by the time you get to fifth grade, you think, what is it? Anyway, that's what these songs say. They say, I want my turn. And it seems like the more I talk, I don't get anywhere. So, I know. From our earlier record entitled Journeys. Let's do a composition entitled Goliath. It's composed by a Mother Chestnut's only baby boy. We hope you enjoy it. Thank you. Thank you so much. You know, the interesting thing is, just recently lost Clark Terry. Well done job he did. It's a blessing to many. And I remember hearing that particular song on the record with him, Oscar Peterson. And kind of dug it, so I went and recorded it. It's on a record to come out this year. While in the studio, I heard the original version, the Brotherhood Man, from How to Win in Business, I believe, by not really trying. And when I heard it, I said, really? How'd they get all that from that? Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the Brotherhood Man. Right now, we're going to do something that we don't know. It's the truth. We never played this here, so it's truly a world premiere performance. Well, this is the second time, but it's still. I'll tell you about it in a few minutes. I had the opportunity to go to Senegal last year, and it was a very special time, and it inspired a set of music, out of which this was one of them that came out. And I have to learn how to play it. Well, I'd like to try it for you. If you like it, let us know. If you don't like it, say nothing. This is entitled Coco City.
Thank you.
now you're in Dayton. As I said before, we had the opportunity to go to synagogue, and it was, as I think about it now, it still affects me in so many great ways. I learned so much. I learned a lot about myself, a lot about music. When I approached the continent, first time I had never been to Africa before, I was told many things of what to expect. I made a promise to myself that when I arrived, I would be an open sponge, not think about what I was told, just react to what happened. Come to find out that I felt very much at home. It's very interesting. I saw so many things. It took me back to my grandmother's house in South Carolina. I remember driving from Dakar to San Luis. It looked like St. Louis to me. But this is San Luis. Seeing the fruit stands, when I looked at my salts, the watermelons, it took me back to my uncle Neal, and it's like, okay, I saw myself there. Walking on some of the dirt roads, I saw myself once again in South Carolina, walking up and down the road from my grandmother's house. Even with the food, I was told, you gotta watch the food. I got sick off of fettuccine Alfredo. They brought this dish. It was called yassa. So be brave. So I wanna check it out, see what it is. When I looked at it, there was some grilled chicken. They said sauce, I called it gravy. With some vegetables, a bit of rice. It's like, and I saw it before. I said, wait a minute. My grandmother made this here for me. I know what this is. So, you know, right hand, fork, boom. I heard the drums. I heard communication. I really got a better understanding of communication. In those 10 days I was there, I learned, I'm still trying to process how to make scales, arpeggios, rhythms, speak. I heard communication there. Every time I think about it, it was mind-blowing to me. And they actually let me play with some of the African musicians. Boy, was that fun. I didn't feel as if I was a fish out of water. The process had inspired a whole set of music. Hopefully, I will be able to record this year. Pieces are called Ami's Dance, there's some of them, Downtown Dakar, and the Door for the Door of No Return. So if you wouldn't mind, could we just play a few snippets of them? You know what I mean? You're going to hear them anyways. We hope you enjoy. Here it is. African Reflection. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I hope that you enjoyed yourself. Once again, how about a great hand for Mr. Neal? Now, young bruh, you've had your official time on this bandstand now. It's first time, it's first really official hour. How about a great hand for Mr. Devin Scott? We hope that you enjoyed what you heard. We hope that you heard a rhythm, melody, or harmony that somehow put a smile on your face. And if that happened, we ask that you carry that good feeling with you as long as you possibly can. As I said earlier, you know, I know you get bombarded all the time about, we have CDs and all, but we do. And it would be great not to have to lug them down south. If you can, get one for yourself, get one for a friend, or get one for an enemy and play a practical joke on them. Anyhow, thank you so very much for allowing us to come this way. It's a great honor for us to play some music for you. And hopefully we can do it again. Hopefully. Thank you. So as I said, tell a friend, tell an enemy, make the enemy your friend. Until the next time, once again, Neal Smith, Devin Stark, yours truly at the piano, Cyrus Chestnut. God bless you all.